Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. This is Raj here. Friends, hope 2024 finds you good. I also hope that you are having a great weekend. Most probably you'll see this video on a Monday or a Tuesday. I'm recording this on the 21st of January at 8:32 p.m. in Toronto. I thought that this will be a very interesting video for many people from my perspective because this is work coming directly from National Institute of Health. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about their latest press release where they said they have succeeded in testing three antibodies, two from simians and one from human, against simian immunovirus or S-HIV. And they tried two doses, and one of them gave 100% result. So we're going to talk about that today. I'll give you the details, and I'll also put the link to the article in the description. So that's what we have for today. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Before we proceed into the meat of the topic today, let me just remind those of you who did not see my last video that we have started the process of moving all HIV content from this channel to our global HIV channel. So the handle for the global HIV channel is at ShareTrekHIV, all one word. And I'm going to put a link to the link in the description below, so that you can click that and directly subscribe there. It'll be a subscribe link. So as soon as you click, it'll go to subscribe in that channel. Because until February, what I will be doing is I'll post the English video here as well as there. And once February starts, I'll just post the English video out there. And that new channel is called as HIV Global. That's the branding I have given it. And the ambition is to go beyond English and Hindi and also do French and Spanish. Because people across the world who have HIV, regardless of their language or nationality, everyone is suffering and everyone needs to get positive information, needs to get up-to-date information. I'm doing a lot of work out here. It need not be restricted just to a limited audience. So anyone among you, if you are able to help me translate from English to French or English to Spanish or English to Hindi, you're most welcome. We already have a volunteer who is helping out with translating all our English blog posts into French. So if you go to sharetrek.com, you'll see French versions of our blog posts. And I'm going to be talking to this person in the coming week to discuss if they would be willing to either present my topics in French on video or at least give us a subtitle. But friends, you will recognize that this is volunteering is difficult for this particular role because we have the schedule of having at least two videos out every week. Therefore, I would prefer that we have three or four volunteers for each language so that you can time slice among yourself because you have your day job, you have things to do, you have your family, other commitments, and there is only so much time you can put for this. Believe me, I know how hard this is because it's taking so much of my time. So when you volunteer, please keep in mind that we'll have to keep the consistency. And that's why if we have four volunteers, we can form a group, introduce you to each other. And then between you, you can always make sure that the French version or the Spanish version comes in time. You can distribute the job among yourself. And everyone will be happy because we'll have a global audience which will get to consume the information in their language. That said, let me go to the main topic. So, researchers at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, or NIAID, conducted a study using three HIV antibodies, including one from a human. And that human antibody was called VRC34.01. And the two antibodies were from two previously vaccinated monkeys. And these antibodies target the fusion peptide in HIV, which is a and that is a key site on HIV surface protein aiding viral entry into cells. And also this particular peptide, which we generally call gag protein, is something that mutates the least when it comes to HIV, because if a mutation happens out there, it can interfere with the fusion. And if fusion cannot happen, that viral particle will not be viable and its lineage will expire. So by natural selection, only a particular type of peptide would survive. So any mutations in the peptide ends the line of that virus. So it's always a very good idea to target that peptide, and that has been the strategy for many vaccines. And the study involved rhesus macaques. These are the type of monkeys found in Asia, and they are generally used for study of vaccination. And the team administered different antibodies or a placebo, followed by a challenge with S-HIV. What it means is that first they gave a group of monkeys different antibodies, and among those three, and then they gave another group of monkeys placebos, and after doing that, they injected them with simian HIV. Monkeys getting a placebo acquired simian HIV, while those with VRC 3.4.01 showed no acquisition at the higher dose and 25% at the lower dose, which means that if the higher dose was adopted, it could give total protection. The vaccine elicited antibodies from monkeys also demonstrated protection, and one variant showing 100% effectiveness. And friends, as you know, HIV in the past has always demonstrated that monotherapy is futile against HIV because it can mutate and make the monotherapy absolutely useless. So three antibodies are better than one. And the one that is showing 100% effectiveness definitely needs the support of the other two. But the question now is, will it be well tolerated? And these are all preclinical trials. These are on non-human primates. The next step is to get into human trials. So there's a lot of questions. Who is going to take this and run with it? And the findings suggest that the fusion peptide-directed antibodies can protect against simian HIV. Concentrations matter, as higher antibody levels correlated with better protection. The study paves the way for further research in designing an effective HIV vaccine targeting the fusion peptide. And friends, one of the most interesting things here is that many times NIAID sponsors a lot of clinical trials and assists various organizations in putting their HIV therapy through the clinical trials. And so this is a very interesting situation. And some of those huge humanitarian organizations like Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation or maybe the WHO or somebody can sponsor taking this concept and putting it through clinical trial and getting it into humans. So the question is, are those initiatives happening? What is going to happen next? So on my part, I have already written to NIH and their contacts, requesting them for a brief information interview to just give us an overview of what I just explained to you. And also, more important, talk with them about their vision of how soon do they think HIV cure might come, and will that cure be a functional cure, or will it be a sterilizing cure? And also about what they plan to do with this this set of antibodies that have demonstrated success against S-HIV. Are they going to themselves develop a vaccine, or are they going to get some other organization to do it? So those are the questions in my mind. And friends, most of you, after I publish this video, might be wondering whether this is a cure or is it preventative or what. So let me clarify that this seems to be a preventative vaccine, because the vaccine was given to the monkeys first, and then they were infected with HIV, and the HIV infection did not take on those which have been given high dose of the vaccine, and the ones that were given placebo developed HIV, and 25% of the ones getting a lower dose of the antibodies developed HIV. So that's the lay of the land. So everything is looking good. The question is, who is going to take this and run to the end so that we can have a human vaccine? How soon can it come? What are the plans of NIAID? So those are the questions. And if we get a chance to talk to NIAID officials, I think those are the questions I'll be asking. And if any of you have any other questions for them, put that in the comments, just in case they accept our invitation for an interview. I would make sure that not only do my questions get answered, but also the questions that you are sending to me, if they are good ones and logical ones, I'll select them for asking the interviews. So that's what I have, my friends. It's a very good way to start 2024. And the link to this article is in the description. Please press the like button if you like this video. It helps with the YouTube algorithms. And once again, friends, don't forget to click the link in the description to go to our new global HIV global channel and subscribe there so that you don't miss any of our future videos starting February. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.